Hello friends, in today's video I will explain you how to plot isometric view of a given question. This is the orthographic projection of a casting. This is the front view and this is the top view. Dimensions are mentioned in this diagram. Okay, to plot the isometric view, first we need a baseline. This is our baseline. Now from any point of this line, draw a line which is 30 degree inclined from the baseline, like this. Now again plot a line from the same point which is 30 degree inclined from the baseline but in the opposite side. Now from the same point plot a vertical line. After that complete a box like this. Then maintaining the relations, these four lines should be equal and parallel to each other. Now again these four lines should be equal and parallel to each other, and in a similar way these four lines should be equal and parallel to each other, like this. After that, giving the dimension, this is the x direction, means it should be 75 mm, like this. You can find it from the front view. This is the y direction, means it should be 50 mm. From the top view you can observe it. And this is the z direction, means it is 37, 25 plus 12, this is 37. Now your box is ready. From the front view you can observe a rectangular surface with two vertical lines. So I am preparing a surface which is 12 mm above the base surface of this box. Okay, so for that I am drawing a line from this end to this end, this end, this end and this end, like this. Adding the relations, this line, this line, this line and this line should be equal and parallel to each other. And in a similar way, this line, this line, this line and this line is equal and parallel to each other. Now giving the dimension, from this point to this point, this should be 12 mm. Now one surface is ready here, which is 12 mm above the base surface of this box. Okay, now from the top view you can observe a rectangular cut in the lower box. So I am preparing a rectangle of size 25 mm by 12 mm. So for that, draw a line from this point in y direction, then in x direction, after that in the y direction, like this. After that, adding the relations, these three lines should be parallel to each other and this line should be parallel to this line. Okay, now you can observe it from this point to this point, it is 25 mm. Marking the distance from this point to this point, it should be 25 mm. Again, from the top view you can observe it is 25 mm and total is 75 mm, means it should be 25 mm. Okay, I'm marking the distance here, this is 25 mm. Now one rectangular surface is placed here. From each corner I'm drawing a vertical line of 12 mm size. Then joining the bottom ends of these lines like this, Now I am trimming the unnecessary portion. Okay, after trimming, your lower box will look like this. Now from the top view, you can observe a rectangular surface of 25 mm by 20 mm. When I project this line in the front view, I get a straight line which is 25 mm from this point. This point is equivalent with this point from the front view. Okay, from the front view, you can observe this point and this point is a single point. And from the top view, you can observe this point is equivalent with this point. So I am plotting this rectangular block on this top surface. This point is equivalent with this point. So to create this, I am plotting a line from this line in the y direction, then up to this line in x direction. Adding the relations, this line and this line should be parallel to each other, and again this line and this line should be parallel to each other. Now giving the dimensions, this is 20 mm, so from this point to this point it should be 20 mm. This is 25 mm, so from this point to this point it should be 25, like this. Now this surface is ready. Here in the front view, you can observe a slant line, but from the top view you can observe it is a rectangular surface, means it is a slant surface. So to create this slant surface, I am joining this line to this line and this distance. From the top view you can observe it is 20 mm, so from this corner to this point it should be 20 mm, like this. Now from the top view you can observe it is a vertical line in the y direction of 25 mm size. So I am plotting a line from this point in the y direction, and the length of this line is 25 mm. So first of all, adding the relation, these two lines should be parallel to each other, and the size of this line should be 25 mm. Okay, now joining these two points. After that, from this point drawing a line in the z direction and another line from this point to this point. Now trimming the unnecessary portions. Now after trimming, your isometric view will look like this. Okay, thank you.